Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston, this is the space station. We are ready for the event.
ESA, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is ESA. How do you hear me?
Loud and clear. Buongiorno a tutti.
Everybody. Hello.
Ciao carissimo, sono Mauro Ferrari, come stai?
Hello my dear, I'm Paolo Ferrari, how are you doing?
Ciao Mauro.
Hello Paolo, I'm fine.
Sentire la tua voce.
What a pleasure to hear your voice.
Paolo, sto bene, che piacere sentire la tua voce.
È piacere anche per me, allora ci siamo visti tante volte.
It's a pleasure for me too, we've seen each other so many times.
Sei un caro amico.
That you're a very dear friend. I've got to say that I have butterflies in my stomach seeing you up there.
Bene, farfalle nello stomaco ce l'ho anch'io.
Well, I also have butterflies in my stomach.
Senti Luca, grazie. Aspetta che ci provo anch'io, vediamo.
Well, tell me, Luca.
Straordinario. Raccontaci della missione Beyond che stai facendo.
This is an amazing situation here, and do me a great favor and tell me about your ESA mission. The space missions are especially those that have four major objectives. The first is your favorite one, probably, and that is science and research. At this time, we have about 150 experiments out of a total of 350 that are being done concurrently. The space station is unique because the environment is unique. We're here at the Vanguard, the point with so many experiments that are being conducted concurrently. And secondly, second point of the mission is certainly the technology aspect. The space station is
a
project at the point, which is used for space exploration, but also to improve the quality of science in a certain sense. Also, thirdly, we want to prepare the road to be able to go beyond to other space exploration. And the fourth point, which I think it's a good thing that you do that at Gaiato, it's a very important and unique aspect, which is the inspiration that is transmitted through the Space Center station to be able to engage in extra space programs to inspire the youth to get involved in space programs. Dear Luca, it's good to hear you say these things. That would be interesting for you to be able to be and do what I am doing now, which is to look people in the eye. And you are a source of great pride for all of us. Tell me, in your opinion, what are the commercial benefits that could arise from this program? I start from a certain point of view. I always ask myself, what added value is there from space work and space travel? The technology that we develop here on board the Space Center is very important in its commercial applications. First of all, our technology can be utilized in Earth and as on Earth as well as in space. You can see with what degree of constancy and precision we're able to conduct our activities here in terms of analysis and photography of the Amazon and the fires in that area. Also in Mozambique, we're able to monitor and to verify and identify not only in a general sense, but in specific instances as well. We have a center that takes in this information, which analyzes atmospheric and land conditions. All of these technologies that we employ up here are also of great value on Earth. The Space Center is also a center for telecommunications, at which the listening, GPS, Galileo, all of these many consequences are extreme use and considerable in number. Space research, space-based research, has demonstrated that much of the money that is invested here in the Space Center, especially in the Space Center, gives us a 80% return, or 1.8 times the investment, an 80% return on investment, i.e. 180% return on investment, paying for the investment plus 80%. Thank you very much. It's important, first of all, to know that for every dollar that is invested, the multiplier comes out to some seven times in terms of activity, economic activity that's stimulated on Earth from the space research budget. And this, of course, involves a lot of work for commercial firms. These are expenses that are made on Earth. In November, for example, we're going to be bringing additional materials, all of which are personal, produced on Earth. On a personal note, I think we should know that in addition to all of that he's doing as an astronaut, Luca is also a notable athlete. I know that you can't do it all by yourself, but I'd like to ask you, given that you're an extraordinary athlete, how do you stay in shape in space? Well, fortunately, here on board, technology comes to our assistance. I personally consider that I'm a mediocre athlete. I've been lucky to be able to be involved in a
sono molto molto
variety of athletic endeavors.
Tornando alla tua domanda, qui
but returning to your question, we are able here to develop over years equipment that enables us to stay in shape,
poco prima
to exercise.
Di questa intervista,
shortly before this interview, I was working here as part of ICE,
per permettere alle nostre ossa e alla nostra muscolatura
to engage in activity that enables our bones to retain their strength and our muscles as well, the musculoskeletal system. Also, cardiovascular work is possible here aboard, and regardless of what our particular attitude is, vertical, horizontal, we are able to return. We, of course, have to remain attached and referencing this particular machine that we're traveling in.
Della mancanza della forza gravitazionale.
Obviously, we would feel the effects of a loss of gravitational force, and so we have to compensate for that.
Fortunatamente abbiamo
in
un certo senso, in allenarci circa 2 ore al giorno.
We have the opportunity to actually work out several times a day, 6 or 7 perhaps.
Grazie Luca.
Thank you, Luca. Salvas.
Qui, come sai, siamo Ambrosetti Forum, no? Ambrosetti Forum.
As you know, we're here at the Ambrosetti Forum.
Adesso certamente number one think tank in the galaxy. Adesso che abbiamo fatto contatto con te.
And now that we are have made contact with you, we feel like we're the most prominent point in the galaxy.
C'è in arrivo un ministerial council di Space 19.
There is there a ministerial council for Space 19? The member states that are involved in this project. Involving especially the European contribution. What do you think, hopefully, will be the outcome and the fallout from the European involvement in this program? I would like to be very positive and optimistic in this sense. I was talking with Nick Haig, an American colleague here at the station. This is a moment of great change and great opportunity. Based on the work that has been done over the past several years, we're able to improve and to change things. And so, by the year 2020, this will be a time in which, over a decade, in which the major space powers will embark on an unprecedented series of exploration projects to try to build something that is almost continuously, almost completely new. The ESA, the European Space Agency, as much as any other and perhaps more, would like to push space research toward a lunar presence and then an interplanetary one, to engage in major projects that go far beyond what we've achieved so far. Most of all, foremost, the development of technology, which is extremely important, how to recycle, how to better utilize resources, how to generate capacity, how to be able to remain for a long term on board this space station, and of course to return to the moon, to prepare the path that will push us toward Mars, and also to be able to lay the basis for very large scale projects. Now, what's the most important in achieving these major projects is international cooperation. No country is able to engage in or to conduct these large-scale projects by itself without the assistance of others. And to begin these projects, the reason is not only because the knowledge base is enlarged on a global basis, but it also we have to believe in the project, we have to want to do it, and those are necessary elements to be able to take the first step in the next series of projects that lie before us.
vengano visti non come un ostacolo, ma come
we have to be able to look at the challenges before us, not as obstacles, but as opportunities for technology to overcome these seeming obstacles, which again are applicable to the Earth. And I believe that this will does exist, this political will, a general scientific and popular will to engage in this large-scale project. I believe all of this exists. You are a true inspiration. I take this occasion to remind us all that clearly you're traveling at 28,000 kilometers per hour. So you're traveling very fast relative to the Earth. Since we have major business leaders present here, could you give us certain examples or some idea concerning the use and its commercial applications here from the work you're doing on the space station?
Well,
I always present examples, for example, from the international standpoint, to enable firms to engage in experimentation here on board. We become the hands and the eyes, the researchers at the disposal of these companies. The Goodyear generates, for example, tire manufacturer Goodyear, which is known worldwide. We have here on board, we have injected certain rubber projects to see how they react in low gravity or zero gravity. And for these tires, we need to understand whether these tires can actually be invested or ingested with an improved quality, which will promise great grants to further improve the quality of industrial products and their safety as well. But as Europeans, we've worked on the Ice Cubes project, which is a project that enables us to utilize a small cubically sized experiments or cubically dimensioned experiments, which can be transmitted via internet to anybody, anywhere on Earth who's involved in it instantaneously, so that those who are involved can follow and monitor on a real-time basis the progress of the various experiments under Ice Cubes. The European experiment also enables us to grow bacteria and microbes in conditions that are not available on Earth, lichens and so forth, and seeds. These then can be used as small agents that can then be able to provide their benefits on the Earth and on other planets such as Mars. And these are things that we are preparing ourselves to be able to face through experimentation. We have this extraordinary platform that is a space station. We're able to do things in scientific research among it that is not available on Earth. Magnificent. Now, you're currently flying over Venezuela. These experiments. We have brought pharmaceutical products aboard.
Well,
tell us about that aspect. When we began the conversation, we're passing near Dorian, the hurricane. We are able to monitor its progress from here near the coast of the United States. You can see that it's heading toward the North American coastline on a north easterly bearing. Now, from over Colombia, of course, was able to photograph many fires, natural resources, natural disasters that are being experienced down there.
Mm. Nessun, non ti preoccupare, solo un istante. Faccio una battuta veloce sul programma per tornare sulla Luna per il 2020.
Very quickly, if you would please give us some information about the program to return to the Moon by 2024. So begin with the Moon.
La Luna è sicuramente un obiettivo.
Is certainly an objective that is. At this time has a very strong attraction and a very deal, strong initiative and impulse at this time. We must remember that when the Moon was landed on during the 1960s, there were, it brought about an enormous technological advance. Generations invested their energies in exploiting the Moon in terms of science and research and popular culture. All of this is necessary in order to be able to engage in the great or giant leaps. We want to be able to participate. We want to be a part of this process. This return presents so very many opportunities for advance and development in this grand project on behalf of humanity as well.
Davvero essere di ispirazione.
And so we really want to be an inspiration for the youngsters of today who in the future will be involved in this project.
Grazie Luca, senti l'applauso di tutti.
Thank you, Luca. You can hear the applause from everybody down here.
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event.
Thank you to all participants from ESA. Station, we are now resuming operational audio communications. The